Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, read by Stig Weems. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. Game or Not, by Archimede Fusillo. At Belinda's school, boys play soccer, girls play volleyball. But Belinda wants to play soccer. She's good at it, really good. But she's a girl. Something's got to give. The dedication reads, for the old soccer boys at St. Joe's and Lawrence and Alyssa. Chapter 1. The lady at reception, Miss Giggly, was always snowed under first thing in the morning. There was no way she was going to take much notice of me and Tash when we handed her the neatly typed note. Mr. Steinman, the sportsmaster, said for us to ask you to please announce this as soon as you can, I said, handing the sheet of paper across the counter. Just as me and Tash expected, Miss Giggly didn't even look up. She sort of grunted under her breath. The request was another thing to add to her already hectic schedule. Mr. Steinman says the notice is, like, heaps important, I added, nudging Tash playfully. Yeah, heaps important, Tash agreed. And we were off down the corridor to our lockers. A few seconds later, our announcement came over the speakers. Bing bong! Sorry for the interruption, teachers and students, Miss Giggly began. But there are some important notices here for your attention. There was a moment's pause. The following students are to report to Mr. Steinman for soccer training at lunchtime today. I looked at Tash, who was rubbing the end of her nose expectantly. The students are, the receptionist began. You can talk, fat ass. I've just been farting. I've got to go toilet. And then the voice cut off. There was a deep breath, some static, and the speakers went dead. I looked around. Every kid had stopped what they'd been doing at their locker and was staring up towards the speaker. It had taken 5 seconds for the names to register before there was an explosion of laughter and catcalls and whistles that brought frantic teachers out of the staff room nearby. I gave Tash a wink. Score another one down to us. We grinned and high-fived our fellow students, proud of having got another one through the system. It was almost too easy. A little forethought, some planning, and a lot of front. I wish you'd let me put the name Do You Need to Poo at the top of the list, Tash told me as we headed for our class. Next time, maybe, I answered, elbowing my way through a group of much smaller grade fours. Watch out! Tash screeched and shoved one of the grade fours out of her way. The grade fours stood back in awe, watching me and Tash strut away. We were legends. Tash grinned. I smiled. We went to our class and sat at our usual desks. We could just imagine the look of horror on Mr. Steinman's face. I was so caught up trying to imagine Mr. Steinman's face when he heard the soccer team's names being called that I missed Miss Franley calling the roll until Tash nudged me. You with us today, Miss Vasantos? Here, I spluttered and raised my hand. Well, now that's a pleasant change, Miss Franley replied. I gave her one of my lopsided grins. Miss Franley was okay for a teacher, I guess. She was young and pretty and into sport, so she couldn't be too bad. Only problem was she was coach of the wrong sports team, the all-girls volleyball squad. Tash and me both played on the school volleyball team. Thing was, though, Tash liked volleyball. I didn't. But it was either volleyball or netball if you were a girl at our school. I hated those silly chest aprons they made you wear in netball, so volleyball it was. Given the chance, I'd much rather have played soccer, as Mr. Steinman knew.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.